Don't be alarmed. Christmas is only 5 days away. And what a better time to have all of our Christmas cooking questions with the one and only Warren Mendes. Hello, Waz. It's great to see you again. Let's get straight into it. People have a lot of questions when it comes to Christmas cooking. First up, Emma asks this. What is an easy and delicious ham glaze I can make?
I think that's the thing a lot of people panic about at Christmas is how to get the perfect ham glaze. Mm. And a lot of people do these complicated recipes, but you absolutely don't need to. My ham glaze is the same every year, and the cheat ingredients is actually butter. And the reason I have butter in the ham glaze is that it kind of browns on the outside and helps to caramelize all that fat on your ham. So the only other ingredients are a lot of Dijon mustard, so a hefty amount. I put in almost half a cup of Dijon.
Holy moly.
And then some apricot jam. So any jam you want, but apricot jam, it's already done. Someone's already done the hard work. The jam's been made and cooked down by somebody else. So all you need to do is mix those together and a decent amount of salt in there. And then this, although it doesn't look incredibly beautiful right now, when this kisses your ham and you start to glaze there, you can see already it's a beautiful and nice thick glaze without you having to cook anything or do anything, and you can have that pre-mix in your fridge ready to go.
Oh, I think it looks beautiful. My eyes are closed when I'm eating the Christmas ham anyway. It's like, mm-hmm. Carl
why
wants...
Why not a fan?
Well, that's it, is it? Was Carl and myself, we need to know. I'm nervous about overcooking the turkey.
Yep.
How do I know when it's cooked perfectly?
Yep. Look, the best thing you can do, especially for Christmas time, is invest in one of those meat thermometers. So if you're cooking your turkey, every oven's going to be different. Every turkey is going to be different as well in how long it takes to cook. So if you use one of those meat thermometers and stick it into the thick part of the leg, when it reaches about 67 degrees, that means your turkey's done. Take it out the oven and give it a rest for about half an hour. As soon as you go into like 70, 75, that's when the turkey really starts to overcook and become dry and worthless, in my opinion. So keep it about 67, let it rest, and it'll be perfect.
And Wazza knows what he's talking about. He's always involved in the Australian Women's Weekly Christmas specials. He makes all the delicious food. Matilda wants to know this, Warren. How do I make Christmas stuffing?
Well, look, stuffing again, I think what you need to do is pick your favourite flavours, because a lot of people end up eating the stuffing before they end up eating the turkey anyway. So one thing I know, our friend Miguel, he likes putting chorizo in the stuffing. So it's a simple stuffing of some chorizo, breadcrumbs, egg, and, you know, whatever herbs you have to hand as well. So if you make a very tasty stuffing, but make sure the ingredients you're putting in are tasty as well, like chorizo is going to give you a punch of flavour, really good smoked bacon is going to give you a punch of flavour, and then that stuffing inside the turkey kind of acts like it radiates flavor throughout the rest of the turkey. So make sure you put some time into that stuffing, because to be honest, it's what we all want to eat at the end anyway.
Oh, most definitely. Now Maria is a woman after my own heart. I only ate this at this time of the year. How can I make the perfect pavlova? How far in advance can I prepare it?
Look, a pav, the good thing about a pav is actually you should do it the day before. So whenever I do my pav, the ratios you always need to remember is for every large egg you use, every egg white, use a quarter cup of sugar. And that's kind of the base that will always work out. So if you have 4 egg whites, it's a cup of sugar, and you kind of use that for your basis. And whenever I'm cooking a pav, I cook it on a really low oven, so about 100 to 110 degrees. And then what I do after about an hour and a half, when you've got that kind of crack on the outside, you turn off the oven and walk away and let that rest overnight. And then as the oven gradually cools down the pav, you're not going to get any cracks. So in actual fact, doing it the day before, you're not stressing during Christmas time or anything, and then it's done and you're stress-free.
Oh, well, the kids are waiting for the presents and I'm waiting for the pavlova. I'm just lying in bed thinking about it. Tomorrow.
You were hanging out for the Viennetta as well. You're like, ah! Finally, this question, lots of people ask this question, in fact. How long can I keep my Christmas ham after Christmas? I reckon Australia Day was. Should chuck it out on Australia Day. What are your thoughts?
I think that's fair. My dad would probably say like 2 weeks, and I'm like saying no.
Push it.
So I think if you had a fresh ham to begin with, you're keeping it for a few days afterwards. Australia Day is probably still okay, but no, definitely no longer than that. Don't follow my dad's routine and go 2 weeks after, because it's definitely spoiled then. But look, if you've got a good ham, you're probably going to finish it in a few days anyway. Put in an omelette, fry it up with some eggs and all that. You're going to probably use it within 2 or 3 days anyway.
Okay, and the best way is to wrap it in a calico bag and make sure that bag is damp. Is that right? Is that the best way to store your ham in the fridge?
That's the best way to store your ham before you're cooking it or anything, for sure. But then afterwards, once you've done all your slicing and that, it can get tend to get very dry. So an airtight container, if you've sliced up your ham, get it all off the bone and everything, slice it up, airtight container in the fridge and it'll be fine. What you can do, if you're not going to use it all up, in that container again, you could freeze it for up to, you know, 3 months, and then you could defrost that ham and then use it again if you do it straight after cooking it.
Beautiful. Great stuff.
Warren, we love chatting to you. We'll see you soon.
Good. Good to speak to you guys.
Bye.
Always, mate.